What's going on? What's going on? All right. Yes, it might not happen. Terrence Crawford versus Errol Spence. If I was to bet on that right now, kind of with the information we kind of, it's a lot of it. Some of it's rumors. You know, there's not 100% confirmation from Terrence Crawford himself. But if certain things happen, and I think are probably going to happen, then there's pretty much little to no chance that fight's going to happen at all. The first thing was with Terrence Crawford signing with MTK Global. I mean, or supposedly he's, you know, he's working with Canahan and he's working with MTK Global. We know that he was in Dubai. He was doing some things in Dubai, and that's the rumor. And what's his name? Bob Arum said that, you know, according to him, that's the case. That's who he's being advised by, MTK Global. The problem with that is that MTK Global, the people that they basically work with in the United States, is top rank. It's pretty much top rank. And then they work a little bit with Eddie Hearn, you know, but mostly with top rank. You know, most of the fighters, that's who they're, you know, they're pretty much co-promoted with or signed to, you know. So if you're working with that guy, obviously this is the path. Like, if you're working with PBC, if you're working with Al Haymon, chances are you're going to be working a lot pretty much with Fox. You're going to be working with Showtime, you know. If you sign to Al Haymon, you're going to be working with PBC. That's pretty much, you know, who they work with. So because of that, I mean, all roads would point to, you know, him pretty much staying with top rank, you know, him staying with Bob Arum. The other issue is that when it comes to MTK, when it comes to, let's say, Fox, PBC, they haven't had a good relationship, you know, as pertains to them and Tyson Fury. You know, we had Tyson Fury take on Dante Wilder, you know, in the first fight, you know, went into a draw, they negotiated. They came out with a deal. You know, one side already had signed. It was a 50-50 deal for the rematch. And Tyson Fury, he walks off. You know, and who does he go sign with? Top rank, Bob Arum. You know, who was Tyson Fury work with? Canahan, MTK Global. You know, they went to the home that they know. You know, and pretty much, you know, instead of kept PBC and pretty much from having this entire fight to themselves. You know, he has two fights over there. After he has the two fights, they come up with a deal with ESPN and with Top Rank, and they do a second fight. They do the second fight. After the second fight, they're supposed to have a third one. It's supposed to be ESPN. They have one fight. Then after that, Fox controls the second fight. You know, and then what happens? You know, they put them through litigations. Obviously, the whole 19 happened, so they couldn't fight for a while. You know, they wanted to wait until they had a crowd and things of that nature. Wilder said he didn't care about no damn crowd. Like, he just wanted to fight. But they wanted to wait for a crowd because, you know, Bob Arum, he's going to get his money. He ain't playing with that BS. So that's what they did. They went ahead and they waited. And then after waiting, all of a sudden, they put Dante Wilder into litigation. You know, they were going to move on to a different direction, I guess, trying to do fights with Tyson, with Anthony Joshua, and put Wilder into a position where he had to go through litigation in order to force this fight. You know, had to force it. So this fight that Fox was supposed to get, everything, all of a sudden, you know, they had all this drama was caused. And after all that drama was caused, finally, obviously, they said Dante Wilder, you know, can go ahead. You know, they must give Dante Wilder his fight. And then they're supposed to have a fight. You know, everything's all set. And what happens? Fury, quote, gets the 19 that somehow cleared in 2 days. Somehow there was a doctor cleared him in 2 days, even though that's not the protocol. But somehow he was cleared in 2 days, and somehow he was able to just fly to the UK. You know, out of protocol, by the way, as well. So, which made absolutely no sense. You know, and all of a sudden he's next to his, you know, his wife and his newborn baby and all his other stuff. Somehow. But whatever, it is what it is. So now they're supposed to fight on October 19th. So they've caused, there's been a lot of hassle when it comes to this, the one time with them really having to deal with this organization in MTK. You know, a lot of hassle. There's been a lot of hassle when it's come to two entities, whether it be with ESPN and Fox, Top Rank and PBC for a major event. A lot of major hassles have gone on. So that's their experience. So now you had this whole situation with 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 Sean Porter and with Terrence Crawford, and they were trying to come up with a deal. And Bob Arum, I guess what they wanted to do was they wanted to do a joint pay-per-view, kind of like they did it with Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder. PBC, Fox, or whatever it is, they said, hell no. We're not doing that BS. You know, they're done with that. They see as if, as you know, they've been put into a position where a lot of games have been played, a lot of BS has happened, and they probably lost a substantial amount of money also, and with the whole process. So it's been a headache. And it's a headache that they don't want to do again. It's something that they don't want to go through again. You know, they'd rather just do their own thing. So they made it, I guess, very clear that, no, we're not going to do any kind of joint ventures at all, period. Either Sean Porter is going to go over there and he's going to fight. And that's it. He's going to get his check. He's going to get a substantial amount of money guaranteed. Or we're going to take over the fight. And if we have to go to purse bids, you know, in order to get the fight, that's what we'll do. But either you're going to control the fight or we're going to control the fight. But we're not doing any kind of co-promotion at all. You know, so that's the place that they're in. So because they're in that mindset, it means that if it came to a situation where, let's say, Terrence Crawford had re-signed with Top Rank, and because he's working with he's working with the entity that he's working with, a unification thing where, you know, both two networks are working together, it's not going to happen. It's not going to be a situation where, let's say, if you went to DAZN, where's it, DAZN and Fox or Showtime, whatever, working together on the fight between those two. You know, if he's with Bob Arum, if he's with ESPN, it's not going to be a situation where it's going to be those two entities working with each other. And it's not going to be a thing where Bob Arum is not going to send him to ESPN, to Fox, in order to do a fight. He's not going to do that. And because they're going to need it's going to be one of those fight with an option where you're fighting two fights on PBC type of thing. Because so they can guarantee their fight, you know, with their fight. It's not going to happen. That right there, not happening. You know what I mean? So, especially with the relationship and the way that it is right now. So, if he, you know, things turn out to be what they seem they might be, you know, and he is signed with, you know, MTK, and he does re-sign with Bob Arum, you know, even, you know, in any facets, and he's still working with ESPN, then this bout's not going to happen. And I think it's going to be a situation where Errol Spence probably fights one more fight. See if he fights Ugas next. He might fight Ugas next, but he might be put into a position where he has to fight as mandatory. But if he comes back, he's able to fight Ugas next. I think he fights Ugas, and after that, I think he moves up. You know, I wouldn't be shocked if he just moved up right away even. Like, if it was a situation where it's like, you know what? You know, Manny Pacquiao's fighting Ugas. So then he just moves up. He's like, you know what? It's going to be too long. I've been at the weight long enough. He's tired of being at that weight. I guess he hates making that weight. So he's not staying there that long. I think he should stay there. I think all the big fights are at 147 pounds. But I don't think he wants to stay there. And the fact that Castano still has his IBF belt puts him into a position where he can actually move up in weight. And he can fight Castano on a pay-per-view. Because Charlo has two mandatories. He has to fight his WBC mandatory. And he also has to fight his IBF mandatory next. Then after that, he has to go fight... Oh, is it his IBF? I believe it's his IBF mandatory. Then after that, he still has the WBA. And he has the WBC as well. So he probably still has to... He has to fight those mandatories as well. So because of that, I'm looking at it probably be a situation where Errol Spence probably does one fight, goes up, Castano fights that other dude, whatever his name is, and whatever, Casazu's son or whatever, knocks him out, or whatever it is, and he comes back, and he fights Errol Spence. I see probably that happening, and because I believe that what the plan is going to be for Bob Arum from the beginning is what he wanted to do is he never wanted to fight Errol Spence. He wanted that Errol Spence fight to not happen. Then he wanted to be a situation where Errol Spence moves up. Then he believes that, you know, 147 pounds becomes wide open for Terrence Crawford to, quote, take over and to, quote, get the belts and, quote, come and become undisputed, which, again, won't happen just due to the fact that you got Keith Thurman, you got Sean Porter, you got Danny Garcia, where those guys can get put into positions to, you know, to grab one of those other belts. You know, you got Ennis. I think Ennis will probably grab like the IBF belt. So in order for Terrence Crawford to become undisputed, he'd have to go through somebody like Jerron Ennis. And I don't see him taking on him. You know, even what's his name might end up getting the WBC his name is just, I don't know why the hell I don't remember his name right now. Junior, Ortiz Junior. He probably could be kind of pushed towards the WBC belt and end up getting a WBC belt around his waist. You know, so then all of a sudden, you know, him, he goes from thinking that he has, you know, this thing is wide open to all of a sudden just being put in a position where he's stuck with one. Maybe he might be able to grab two belts. Maybe, you know, we'll see. But for right now, you know, he is fighting Sean Porter. It should be a good fight. Hopefully it happens. I'm still have questions if that fight actually happens. But if it does happen, you know, it'll be great. You know, I definitely will be hyped about it. Then about a week before the fight, I'll be hyped about it. And I'll probably go watch that because I think it's going to be epic, you know. But we'll see what happens. But yes, if he does re-sign with Top Rank, if he is working with MT, I believe that you can kiss that Errol Spence versus Terrence Crawford fight completely goodbye. Won't be happening. But we'll see what goes on. For now, like, subscribe, share. I'm out.